Protesters demanding full universal suffrage took to the streets and stayed there for 75 days. Joshua Wong helped organize the students, and he played a big part in the so-called umbrella movement. And he joins us now live. Joshua, let's talk about the bill. It's been debated today. The debate will continue tomorrow. And supporters of the bill say that this could be the last chance for Hong Kong to change its election system. What do you make of that?
Point of view, I just believe that we're trying to, all of the pandemic supporters try to hope all of the council members to vote down the political reform package. However, I think this is just the starting point for us after the umbrella movement. Even we try to vote down the package that proposed by government, which just led the politician who love Communist Party to be the candidate. We still believe that we need to continue to fight for democracy and freedom.
And let's talk about that bigger fight for democracy and freedom and the year 2047, because that is the year when Hong Kong loses its special status. Yeah. That's when Hong Kong is fully absorbed into China. So, Joshua Wong, what do you plan to do? How do you plan to fight for Hong Kong?
Actually, this is also the next goal for myself and Scholarism. Democracy is not only talk about universal suffrage. We also need to get the right to use referendum to decide the future of Hong Kong after 2047. As we know that we still can have rule of law, freedom of speech, and right to organize assembly under one country system. But actually, we are not sure that after 2047, whether Hong Kong SAR will turn back to be one of the mainland China country and turn back to one country, one system or not. So actually, after umbrella movement and after the discussion on political reform package, the second goal for us is to fight for the right to organize referendum to decide the future of Hong Kong after 2047.
So you're calling for a referendum to determine the future of Hong Kong after 2047. Joshua, you were recently denied entry to Malaysia because local officials didn't want to jeopardize ties with China. So how do you challenge a government that is so powerful and so far-reaching?
Yeah, this really a question that some of the supporters of Scholars have also asked me. As we know that while Communist Party would not let Hong Kong people to get true universal suffrage, actually it's more harder for us to get the right to have referendum compared to get the true universal suffrage. But from my point of view, if we try to ignore the problem of the future of Hong Kong after 2047, we do not propose the right to have referendum in this moment. 20 years later, we still may need to face the situation that we may turn back to be one country, one system. So in my conclusion, no matter fight for referendum to decide Hong Kong future is more challenging compared to get back true universal suffrage. The new generation of Hong Kong after umbrella movement, we will try to still persist on our principle to change something impossible to be possible, to fight for our future.
It sounds as if, you know, today's debate over this bill is just a blip on the radar for you. You want to focus on the bigger goal here, to expand democracy in Hong Kong, to extend the freedoms in Hong Kong beyond 2047. So how logistically and through action do you plan to do that? How do you plan to recharge the umbrella movement? And when will we see the return of mass Occupy action on the streets of Hong Kong?
I don't think that in this year we will have the new Occupy action in this moment. But I think after the political reform discussion, the next goal for us is to increase the public awareness on the problem of the future after 2047. And Hong Kong, this November and next year September will have the election on the District Council and Legislative Council. We hope more of the pan-democrats candidates can focus and to emphasize on the importance of all of the voters or Hong Kong citizens concerned about the future of Hong Kong. If Hong Kong turn back to be one country, one system after 2047, all of the exist rights, freedom and rule of law will decline in the future.
And a final question for you, and it's a question I've asked you before, but the situation has changed, the stakes are higher, we've seen China either indirectly or however express its influence on nations overseas. Are you afraid of China? Knowing what the Communist Party is capable of, do you think about and fear how they could respond to your ongoing protest?
Actually, the ongoing protest, one thing that we do admit that is it's not easy to win in the victory, to win or get victory within the battle. Actually, after the umbrella movement, we still can't get to the universal suffrage or direct election. But I just believe is even Communist Party is really have is it really can affect a lot of country. I can't enter mainland China. I can't enter Malaysia. And actually, it have a lot of influence. But the new generation of Hong Kong, we still believe that today the ruling class and Communist Party dominate our future. But if we persist on what we believe in, we finally, in whole of the war, we finally can win. Although in last year battle, we could not win. But in the future war, we finally can get back the rights of Hong Kong people.